back into something you said in the last hour. You said it wasn't such a great day for the prosecution, and I would imagine this particular witness had a lot to do with that. There was a lot to be gained on both sides. But explain a little deeper what you thought about today's presentation by the prosecution.
Well, with this witness in particular, I think this is Lieutenant Marcel.
Yes.
He really did some damage with agreeing with Mr. Nelson on cross-examination. In fact, was a very friendly witness to Mr. Nelson. But what I thought, here's what I can't wrap my brain around. You've got these training witnesses that are not allowed to testify to the ultimate question of whether or not the force that was used in this particular case was reasonable. So because of a motion in limine that was ruled upon before trial started. So you have that factor out there, but yet you're bringing all of these people in and you're asking them hypotheticals like they are expert witnesses. And then you're not asking the ultimate questions. So I don't know that it's very effective. So you get this these disjointed hypothetical questions that really aren't applying to the facts of this particular case, right? And it's just too disjointed to make sense. And then what's happening then on the, you know, when Eric Nelson then comes up and starts asking his questions, he's able to do the same thing and ask questions that are very favorable to him. So the prosecution just didn't really score any points with this particular witness. I think he was the worst for the prosecution this morning, in fact. I also think that the use of the crowd photo was a terrible idea. I mean, they grabbed the one screen grab of the crowd that happens to show the MMA boxer getting pulled back up onto the curb. I mean, that I can't wrap my brain around. So, you know, why not show a video here of them telling, you know, the officer that he can't breathe? You know, there just could have been a much more effective use of evidence that was used for this witness, or just to get him in and out. He took my class. He knows how to do this stuff. This is not a proper technique for a knee on the neck, and get him out.
Yeah, you know, I agree with you 100%. I might not have even called this guy, but again, you know, I guess they're trying to establish the fact of just how much Derek Chauvin knew and the knowledge, and that's going to go eventually to the intent. But overall, how do you feel about the prosecution's case thus far in terms of proving their case against Derek Chauvin?
I think that they are doing a very good job. I like how the evidence is coming in terms of they started out. I always think about my cases like a story. You're telling a story. You're directing a play or a movie, right? And particularly in a case like this that everybody is watching. And so they're starting from the beginning of the story. You know, they call in the people that were there that witnessed everything, the store clerk that took the $20 bill, the witnesses that saw everything happen, the little girl that, you know, that shot that famous video. They really did a great lead into this story. And I like the way that they're doing it. Now they're getting into the more technical evidence. So now we're talking about the use of force. You know, so we've already gone through the story. Now we're talking about the use of force. I would suspect next will be, you know, he gets taken away, he dies. Now it's going to be the autopsy and the evidence of, you know, the coroner's report coming in. So they're really doing a nice, good job with the linear, you know, the way people think. They want to be read a story from beginning to end, and it really doesn't work well when you have to tell things out of order. That also might be why they didn't want this one witness today to testify, in fact, about the excited delirium. It was because it would throw off their story, you know, their how they describe it. So I think that that's kind of what happened with that as well. But I think that they're doing a fantastic job. They're really setting forth, you know, what happened and why it was wrong.
So I agree. I think they're doing a fairly good job with possible exception that, again,